This video is about making a guitar template. I went online to find a guitar template that I liked. I went to Electric Herald and found this Charvel Eddie Van Halen 5150 guitar template. Downloaded it. This is what it looks like. It doesn't give you a great deal of information, but it does give you a shape. Then using Inkscape, I went to File, Import, found the file I wanted and imported it. I wanted to make a left-handed guitar, so what I did was highlight the picture, come up to here where it says flip selected objects horizontally, and that's basically it really. It just flips it across. Unfortunately, all the writing is the other way around. Now what I want to do is I only want the body, to be able to build the body template. I'm not going to muck about with the neck just yet. So I go over to this Bezier Curves and Straight Lines tool and draw around the guitar body. Come up to this Select and Transform Objects tool, this black cursor up here, this black arrow. This is highlighted. Now you want to press and hold Shift, click inside this box, and you'll see this box highlight as well. Now you want to go up to Object, Clip, and Set, and that removes the rest of the picture. Now what I want to do is come up to Extensions, Render, Grids, come to Grid, and Apply. Now close that. Now I've got a grid over my drawing, so when I print this off full size, this will be about four pieces of A4. This grid will help you align it up properly so you can stick it together. Now what I want to do is put this onto this here, the area that I want it to be on. So what I do is come up to File, Document Properties, come down to Custom Size and Resize Page to Drawing or Selection. Now I have the drawing here, so now what you want to do is export it as PNG. I'm going to change the name of that. Put it to Guitar Body and export. Now what I want to do is, when I want to print that, I'm going to print it in Paint. So here it is here, and it's quite large. So when you come up to Print, you go across to Print Preview, and you can see there, it's not good, that's basically one size of A4. So come up to Page Setup and Scaling, adjust to 100%. Now I take away the margins. Now if I click OK, you can see that that's taken up, it's about 8 pages I think. So I want to go back to Page Setup and choose Portrait. So that's 1, 2 pages. So pages 1, 3, 4, and 5. We print those individually, we'll get the size we want on 4 pieces of A4. Then once you've printed those, you want to cut off these edges with a guillotine, or with a pair of scissors. I used a guillotine, and then it makes it a lot easier to stick them together. So this is the end result. Once you print it off, I've taped it together, so you've got 4 pieces of A4 after cutting off the edges, and you can line it up using these squares. Makes it a lot easier to line up. And then I just stuck it to some 10mm MDF. So tomorrow I'm going to cut around this with a jigsaw. I'm not too sure about the neck pocket. I think I might make something separate for that. I'm probably going to cut out
I have to cut these out, obviously. So that way, once I've clamped it down, I can just cut this out in one go. Drill into it and then route around it. And I stuck this one using some spray adhesive, which is why it's all sort of discoloured like this. It's a little bit lumpy, but otherwise these are all fairly straight lines. So yeah, the next video will be a jigsaw video, or cutting this out with a jigsaw. So if you want to leave a comment or a like and a subscribe, that'd be great. Thanks very much.